All right, back to the horn. So I'm doing the final fit and finish on everything, or final fitting, and I have to refinish and remove acoustic armor in places before I can put everything together. So here's the horn so far. And I have the first, second, and third slides and the tuning slides all done. Saturn water keys are done. Got my third slide stop screw. That's finished. And I even finished the first valve. So I want to show you some of the features that are on this horn, and at the same time, let you see some of the final process so you can see how we put it all together. I also have a piece of paper towel lodged way down there, so I still need to get that out. And the next step right now is to assemble the second valve and put that in and make sure it's good. I've already lapped all the valves and all the slides, so I'm hoping that I did that well enough so that these just go together at this point. When assembling a brand new horn, I put grease on every thread, and I usually will put it on either side of the thread or both sides so that it really does get all the way around. These are our high efficiency stems. I'll show you the next one so you can see what that looks like. The valve guide, if you ever take your pistons apart, the valve guide only goes one direction, and you need to look inside your valve casing to see how we have aligned the little tabs on the guides. So once in a while we get a phone call and somebody says, hey, I can't get my horn to work, and it's because they took those apart and then put them back together backwards. So I'm putting a little bit of grease on every thread, including the finger button, and that'll just, you know, hopefully lube it for the next year or two so that we don't have any problems taking it apart. I use Ultra Pure on our horns. I find that that oil really works well for brand new pistons. Now I put the second in, and again I greased all the threads. I just need to grease the top of the top cap threads. Because that one has so much surface area, I put a little more on. And that should go on nice and smooth, which it does. And now I have the first two valves together. And I will spend some time really just fingering through things and making sure this is smooth and perfect. But I'll give you a close-up of what it looks like so far. All right, I'm gonna put some grease on the second bottom cap thread. And as you can see, I have a method here, which is to finish one at a time. So I start with the top cap and the piston and the finger button, and then I go to the bottom cap. And now I know I'm done with the second slide and the second piston. So we only have one more. Now this one, I said I would show you some close-ups. Here's a close-up of the piston. And this is number 3. Once in a while we get people that say that there are no markings on them. Well, they are all marked, they always have been. The upper of the piston, which is the barrel, does have a number on it. There's a number 3 right there. This is the stem that's going on this horn, which is one of our custom stems. This is a high efficiency stem. It's machined out of solid brass right here in our shop, and it's got some spirals to it. And our top caps, of course, are made right here, as is pretty much everything. And then the finger buttons, these are the Mod 2 designs, so they are actually in two pieces. Although this set really wasn't intended to come apart, you could use the tool, take the base and the top off, and then swap the parts. So if you wanted to make this finger button inlay, which is dichroic or dichrolam, if you wanted that to fit a different horn, you could. So we could put a bottom on here that fits a Yamaha or a Bach or a Monette, and then put it all together. And it's pretty simple. The tool is simple and the process only takes a few seconds. Okay, so now I'm going to put these together. I have this assembly, and then I need to put the valve guide in. Again, it only fits one direction. So on a Harrelson trumpet, the number will face me, and I'll take the smaller tab, because there are two of them. I'll take the smaller one and I'll make it face the right hand side. And usually it's not going to go in the wrong way, because one side is bigger than the other. So if it goes in, we're usually good. Now I need a little grease on the stem. I'm going to screw it together. Because these are the high efficiency stems, then it may not be as easy to seat the spring in the top or at the bottom of the stem, which is the top of the barrel. And that's because there's less of a recess there. And that's where I've added some mass. All right, and then we're going to put some oil on this one. I'm going to make sure that number three is facing the receiver. And then lock it in place. And then let's test it for a second. Looks good. Now I just need a little grease again on the threads to the top cap. And I want to be very careful that I don't get that grease on the piston. I have had customers who have gotten their brand new horn and then discovered that one of the pistons was really slow and it was just some of the tuning slide grease got on the piston, and they thought there was something wrong with their horn. But a quick cleaning, wiping it clean, maybe even rinsing it, and then reapplying oil usually would solve that problem right away. So I'm extra careful to make sure I don't get any of that grease that we do need on the threads into the pistons, so that we don't have that problem. All right, all three of them work beautifully. And of course, I knew they would because I had just lapped them and got everything fit. So you're really just seeing the very end of the process. I've already spent a couple hours this morning just getting this horn ready for this video. And I greased the bottom, put the final bottom cap on. And now this horn is fully assembled. And I'll tell you what, it's beautiful. This is our black midnight finish in acoustic armor. And this is also our gold in the trim and the receiver and on the Saturns. And this one has a personalized name in the lead pipe. So I'm going to take just a minute and check the fit of that. I'll take the receiver off so you can see it. I've already greased it. I need to put an insert in here to be able to play the horn and play test it. For now, I'm just going to put it back on. On the receivers, when you screw it together the first few times, especially in acoustic armor, it may need to, have a little extra tightening a few times. There's a part of the thread at the very end that's designed to lock it in place and kind of make it tight. So let me hold it up close so you can see this. That's really all around just a beautiful horn. So we have the machined bell crook style R. This is machined out of 5 pieces and then welded and silver soldered together. It's a Summit One model, meaning we have the higher efficiency, lighter bracing and finger rings. Let me get my fingers out of there so you can see those. And it has a style R tuning slide, which is also fully machined. And that is 4 pieces. And this one, it's marked 4-7, meaning it's got a number 4 lead pipe and a number 7 bell. Half inch mod kit on the top and the bottoms. The spiral stems I just mentioned, we'll get close so you can see those. Those are pretty cool. And the dichro lam for the finger buttons. It says Summit One in my signature up here, On this side has a Harrelson logo. Let's see if we can get a shot underneath. Underneath would be the build date in Denver, Colorado. Probably not going to get that on camera because it's hard to see. And then the lead pipe and bell is stamped underneath there. There you can see it, just barely. All right, so the entire horn is together. I don't have the mouthpiece for this horn because the client has it, but I did fit a mouthpiece and a back bore to ensure we had the correct size nut, which would then match up to the mouthpiece right there. So this horn is ready for a play test, and all I need to do is pull out a little paper towel that's stuck way down there, and then I will play test this horn. And there's one more thing I need to do. I also need to fill this signature so that it's black on gold. So I'm going to pause the video, do that, show it to you, and let you hear the horn. Okay, I filled the signature, so now you can see it. And I'll leave that to dry for a minute. And then once it's dry, we will play test this horn. Okay, I got the horn all set up. I took that paper towel out that we had plugged it up for the acoustic armor. And now I can play it. I put my mouthpiece in there, which fits just fine with our standard size nut. And I'm gonna play it. And then we're gonna put an insert in there. Just fine, but there's no insert in the receiver, meaning I need to take this off now that that's dry, and an insert goes right here. So I'm going to put one in there. This is what our insert set looks like, and I'm going to grab one that's middle of the road, and I just snap it on right here, and then I screw the receiver back on. And there, it's back together. This insert is a 6 gap, which means 60 thousandths, and it's a Venturi of 344. So we'll see how that plays. All right, so I solidified some things. Playing it without an insert, you can do that, but it's not recommended because the insert system was designed so that you could adjust flexibility, slotting, and airflow. And the airflow would be the 344. Which is 344 thousandths of an inch. The slotting and the flexibility are in kind of a sliding scale. You have a lot of slotting over here with a large number, meaning more gap and a bigger impedance change. And on the other side is more flexibility, meaning less gap, less impedance change. So on the inserts, we number them 2 through 18. A number 2 has more flexibility, a number 18 has more slotting, and right now, we're at a number 6, so we're towards more flexibility. You can hear it's very easy for me to slide around on the horn. So I can go back and forth very, very easily. I'm going to take the insert out and demonstrate. I'll take this off one more time so you can see it. Bring it up close. So I take this insert off. And I'm going to put that back where I found it. Now this time I'm going to go all the way to a number 18, which is the biggest. So we have the most gap with this one. Snap that on. Screw the receiver on. Got a lot of grease on there. And now I'm ready to play. Can you hear how this horn wants to lock in on each partial? I don't have that flexibility I had before. Now I'm locking in harder than before. So when I'm playing in the upper register, you hear me define each note. I'm not intentionally doing that. It's actually too much gap for what feels comfortable to me, but it's an exercise, really just to show you how changing that can have such a drastic difference. So thanks for watching the assembly, final assembly of this Summit One in acoustic armor in the black midnight and the matte gold.